A place to be, to groom your words. A place that is secure for the rest of mine. No other place but Burial Schools. Burial Schools is the best.
Good day, lovely friends and my viewers. How are you doing today? I believe you are staying safe. You're welcome once again to another interesting time on our e-learning platform. I remain your teacher, Miss Julie Praise. Well, nice friends, in our last class, we looked at a topic, regular and irregular verbs. Okay, and we did a whole lot of examples, okay, to help us understand that topic properly. Well, for today, we're going to be going into a very nice topic, and our topic for today is conjunctions. I'd like you to repeat after me. Let's go. Conjunctions. Well, in our today's class, we're going to be looking at the meaning of conjunctions, examples of conjunctions, and we're going to be going ahead to also look at conjunctions in sentences. So I'd like you to follow me because remember I said that learning is fun. So let's learn. Now we're going to be looking at the meaning of conjunction. What is a conjunction or what are conjunctions? Conjunctions are words that join two or more words together. Alright? We could say that a conjunction is a glue that brings two or more words together in a sentence. So I'm going to put it down on the board. Alright. On the board, I have written out the meaning of conjunctions. Like we have already seen, I said that conjunctions are words that do what? That join words, a group of words. And I went ahead and said that conjunction is a glue that joins words together in a sentence. Now let's look at the board. We have conjunctions are words that join words, a group of words together in a sentence. Now we're going to be going ahead to look at examples of conjunctions. Now there are many, okay, they are not only limited to the seven that I have listed on the board, but for your level, we'll just take these seven. So let's go. Number one, we have and. A-N-D. And. Number two example, we have because. Because, okay, we have or, O-R, or. We have number four, but. Number five, so. Number six, unless. And number seven, we have though. Now, look at these words. We say they are conjunctions. Okay, let's look at number one. We have a word like bread. All right, now let's look at examples. Like I said, use these examples in sentences. We have a word like bread, akara. Bread, akara. Does it make sense? Or we could say bread and tea. Let's leave bread and akara aside. Okay, let's use bread and tea. I know a lot of my nice friends, they love to take bread and tea for breakfast. So we have bread, tea. So for us to make use of this conjunction, we could use and. Bread and tea. Bread and tea. Or sometimes, my nice friends would say, Mommy, I want to eat beans or rice. You can see we've used the conjunction or, you see, the or is doing what? It's linking the word rice and linking the word beans together. Alright? Alright, next we're going to be looking at these words in sentences. I'm going to write them on the board and I'm going to go through them together. So nice friends, on the board we have examples of conjunction in sentences. Examples of conjunction in sentences. Now on the board, as you can see, we have five sentences. Number one, we're going to read. I'll read and then you read after me. I have two goldfish and a cat. So you're going to read after me. Let's go. I have two goldfish and a cat. the best policy. It is good to be honest. So we people liked her because she was honest. Now the conjunction in this sentence is what? Because. Beautiful. Number four, we have, I want cake, but I am not allowed. I want cake, but I am not allowed. So the conjunction here is, but, B-U-T. Then the last but not the least, the teacher is talking, so we need to listen. The teacher is talking, so we need to listen. So the conjunction in that sentence is so. So see, we have, I have two goldfish and a cat. I like tea and bread. People liked her because she was honest. I want cake, but I'm not allowed. And the last but not the least, the teacher is talking, so we need to listen. Before we call it a day in our today's class, I'd like to leave us with a few home activities for us to do. Alright, nice friends, for our homework for this week, the instruction says, circle the best word for each sentence. Now, if you look at the word closely, we have two words in brackets. Okay? So, what you're going to do for me is that you're going to write out the best word that suits the sentence. For number one, we have, it is cold, dash, I wear my jacket. And we have so and but in brackets. So, you're going to pick one word that suits this sentence and write it there for me. Number two, I know Michael, dash, I don't know his brother. In brackets, we have but and or. Three, John got dressed, dash, forgot his socks. In brackets, we have but and so. Now, the last but not the least, we have number four. We washed the dishes, dash, we put them away. And in brackets, we have and but. Alright, nice friends, we've come to the end of today's class. I hope you do take care of yourself and you stay safe. Till I come your way again, I love you. Bye-bye.